And one of our young co-producers was just again and again, he was Mr. Craigslist. Like, if we didn't have anything, just, I'll put an ad on Craigslist. We can't find it, I'll put an ad on Craigslist. And he would always come up with stuff. So we're going, I can't find them all of the bed. He goes, I'll put an ad on Craigslist. And I'm thinking, yeah, right, I mean, they're going to advertise abandoned malls. And sure enough, within a day or two, a woman called up. And she said, I know where there's an abandoned mall. And I think I can get it for you, but you're going to have to pay me a finder's fee. And, you know, he negotiated with her. I think it was something for us, and it was like maybe $500, which was, we paid that in a second to get the place. And it turned out that this was, like, not too far from LAX, Los Angeles Airport there, is a kind of a town that's sort of fallen on hard times called Hawthorne. And it was called the Hawthorne Mall. And it's just like you see there. And it was, but it had no light. So you have to go in there with flashlights. And it was funny because as we were filming there, there was another crew from, I think it was that website, Funny or Die, and they wanted to shoot something in there. We ran into them, we're talking to them. They were going through the whole thing, taking mold samples of the air because they didn't want to expose the crew to some kind of mold. And I just said, just forget the mold tape. We're shooting here no matter what. And nobody came down with anything that got me. We spent two days in that place, and it was just gorgeous. And I wish we could have, I could have even seen more of it, because it went for, you know, this whole, you know, it was a full-on huge mall that was just been left for 8 years for rot.
Well, it's very effective in the film. So do we have time for one more question? Does anyone have the last question? Yep.
I love the film. I noticed that based on the fantasy, some of your other horror films, you have pretty active protagonists. They're engaged, they're pushing the movie along, they're not just victims waiting to get killed by the monster or the killer. Is that intentional choice, or that's something how it's going to work out? Or?
Absolutely intentional. I hate those kind of movies. I don't like victims. I like, you know, they got to go down swinging. And so that's what I've always try to, certainly in the Phantasm movies. I think in John Dies, it was really more, rather than going swinging, it's just that they were trying to make sense of what was happening, which was impossible. So that's when they were befuddled throughout the movie. But thanks for saying that. And I guess that's all. I want to thank you all for coming out tonight. This is really